Hello, what is an array? Very short, just look at these pictures. This is an array, 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 array. Forget all the other explanations. These are arrays. So just imagine a drawer cabinet. The usage is also exactly the same as you use the ones in the programming languages. For example, if you want to tell your girlfriend or your boyfriend to take the keys out of the drawer, then she or he might ask, which one? And you say, well, the first one from the top, or the second one from the bottom. So you somehow have to identify these drawers. And if we go one step further, it's the same with here, it's just more complicated. So if you want to explain that the keys are in here, then you can say something like the second row and the third column, or the second row in the middle. So there are various ways of explaining this, but the basic concept is the same. You always have to identify one drawer out of the all ones, out of all the others. And this is exactly the same as the array in the programming language. We now get a little bit more technical. You sometimes, depend on your programming language, express an index through these brackets. So for example, you could say the index in this bracket refers to as the row, and in this bracket refers to as the column. It's exactly the same usage. If we go back to here, it's the same, just that you have only one dimension, so you just refer to as the row. So I hope now you got a good understanding or a good image in your head of what is an array. Now let's discuss the rows and the columns. So there are actually teachers out there who say the first one is the column and the second one is the row. Basically, this is pretty wrong in so many ways, but the opposite is also so wrong in so many ways. So we don't care about what's right and what's wrong. We just care about what is best for us to imagine. In the end, it doesn't matter which is the column and which is the row. Just use what is better for you to imagine, and everything works fine. So for me, and this is the reason why I put it like this, as a human being, I have a buddy hate. And when I'm searching the drawers, I usually search at first in the first row. Why is it like this? Because they are the most easiest to handle. And then I go down slowly, because it's very hard to kneel down for just taking out these drawers. And also, the usual style of the drawer cabinet is this one, and not the... I mean, you have some of these for your television or something, where you have two drawers like this, but you don't have four, right? So it's usually like this. You don't have this, right? So it's usually like this here. So we don't need that. So this is just my explanation why I think this is the row and this is the column. But as I said before, this doesn't matter. If your teacher wants to believe it's the opposite, then just believe it's the opposite. And if you think it's much easier to imagine that the first one is for the column and the second one is for the rows, then do it like this. Just use the imagination. It's better. That's better for you. Because in the end, what is written in the memory is totally different from what you might imagine. The memory looks more like this. So this might be the item with the index 0 and 1 and 2 and 3. So now in the memory, what would happen if we just add a second dimension? So you might think, okay, now because our image is like the drawer cabinet, we should add another dimension down in here. And if we do like this, the first dimension is indeed the column and the second dimension is indeed the row. So this might make sense, but this is pretty wrong. Because what actually happens is that the next dimension will start right after the first dimension. So it's just a long, long row. This destroys basically every image you can make in your head. And what you also might think is, well, okay, if this is just one row, then I could just count here more. So if I reach the 3, I can just go 4 and 5, and then I would reach here. And yes, this is indeed true. If you just count up here and just leave this one 0, then it's okay. You can also iterate through all the dimensions you have. But depends on your programming language and the compiler. I don't want to get too specific here, but one thing to remember maybe, if you're working in a language like C++, you mostly have this, you mostly have this like here in a row. But if you, for example, use Python, then you might have an array that is spread all over the memory. Why is that so? We don't care, but it is. So in the end, what I tell you with all these things, just imagine a drawer. If you imagine an array, drawer cabinet, and don't be worried about the columns and the rows. Just use whatever suits best to you. And a little bit of a postclaimer. If you think this explanation was helpful, I would really like to see it in maybe the comments. Not for searching statistics, but just to know if this is really what helps. For me, I think the explanations in schools and universities of arrays are pretty sad and hard to understand and very technical, and I think it's much easier to just imagine this.